Morning, everybody. Got my cup of coffee, and I happen to have an engine sitting next to me. I'm in the middle of taking the original 260 out of my Sunbeam Tiger and putting the Redline Rebuild 289 in it, for those of you who haven't watched the first few episodes of this. Last week, we got the front subframe and all that stuff out of the way. This week, it was my comedic struggle to get the engine out of the car. So, spoiler alert, it is sitting here, but it was not easy to do by myself, and we had to get sort of medieval with the process. So it was a lot of fun. I hope you guys are enjoying this. I'm trying to get with it, make the spanners move around a little bit as you guys really wanted to see. So here's this week's episode. Here's today's first error. Pulled the drive shaft out, and with the car jacked up, a lot of transmission fluid come out of the back. Got to pan under that now. Here's another update. Let's see, I can't get the camera underneath the car to pull the exhaust system off, and I managed to drop one of the wrenches into the bucket that I'm using to collect all the draining transmission oil. So this is going great today. So what we're trying to do is to lower now the engine, the whole body of the car. The whole engine's got to sit down in that little cradle I made, and I've got to leave enough room to support the tail shaft of the transmission on a rolling jack. So then I can try, I got to get the motor mounts out of the sides once it's on the ground. We're just going to see how all this goes. This is all brand new about trying to see if this engine will fit on this dolly. Is I've got to undo three motor mount bolts each side and then lift the body up off but keep the tail shaft up a little so then I can start to work the whole thing out because the back of the transmission is still in this big cross member in the back, so it's got a few inches before it comes free, and then I can really raise the body up and get it out of the way up, and then of course I've got to work around that, so probably we'll end up lifting it way up, jack standing it again, way up, which is gonna look terrible, and then rolling it out of the way. Then the body is still supported by the crane under here. The engine is now sitting flat on the trolley I made. So if this is done right, then when I take these out on both sides, nothing should happen. It should just sit right where it is. Now, it's not entirely possible, I guess. I'm not going to get that lucky. But you can kind of tell when they're, you know, stripping themselves or galling real bad because they just don't ever really want to come out. You know, even when you get to the very end, it's like a lot of effort.
And once you get these moving, they're coming out just fine. I don't see any weird shiny spots. It doesn't look like it's, you know, cross-threading itself on the way out, anything like that. So that's a relief. So again, and I haven't seen it shift any. So I'm going to leave that bolt. I'm going to go do the other side, and I'll come back to this. Okay, we're back on this side, the other side free, and it did move slightly, just slightly, when I did the other one, so. Okay, there we go. We gave it just a little bit of help. Okay, bolts are out. Everything's out, so I ought to be able to lift the body up off and then start to do the dance.
This is where two people is super helpful. Yeah, it's gonna come forward a little bit. I wonder. Here's what I figured out, and I'm going to try and work with mechanical advantage to help the fact that it's just me working on this. And Rube Goldberg is alive and well. So here we go. What we have is my cradle. And I've put an extra piece in there that I've hollowed out to fit that round, that more rounded part. I've got this set up here around the bottom of the dowel. It goes, if you follow here, to a come along, okay? Come along is connected to the front of my Toyota Century Japanese limousine, which makes a lot of sense because it's a big, sturdy thing, and I don't think it's going to go anywhere. So I think what I can do on this nice, massive tow hook, this is the plan. I raise the body up a little bit. I keep a little tension on the engine now. That way, as it frees itself up and it gets in the right place, it'll sort of inch itself out by itself. And then I can click, click this a little bit, adjust the body a little bit, click, click, and before long, the body will be up, the engine will be out, sort of. I really hope that's what's happening, but good old Japanese Toyota Century. Okay, let's get back to it. I'm very happy right now. Very, very happy right now. Whoa. The original 260 is out. The 289 will be going in soon enough, and there are some surprises with that. So I think in the next video, I'll talk a little about some even better enhancements that are happening to that motor before it goes in, okay? Thanks, I'm a mess. Sorry.